Catholic leaders are voicing concern after Attorney General William Barr announced Thursday that the federal government will resume using the death penalty. The order quickly came under fire from national Catholic prelates, with Bishop Frank Duane, chairman of the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops Committee on Domestic Justice and Human Development, saying he is deeply concerned by the move, explaining, in 2015, Pope Francis, echoing the views of his predecessors, called for the global abolition of the death penalty. He went on to state, a just and necessary punishment must never exclude the dimension of hope and the goal of rehabilitation. And Catholic organizations agree. Chrisanne Valancourt Murphy, executive director of the Catholic Mobilizing Network Against the Death Penalty, responded to the announcement by saying, resuming federal executions, especially by an administration that identifies itself as pro-life, is wrong-headed and unconscionable. The Justice Department's declaration comes after a nearly two-decade hiatus of executions by the federal government, beginning with five death row inmates that the Justice Department says are, quote, convicted of murdering and, in some cases, torturing and raping the most vulnerable in our society, children and the elderly. The United Nations also spoke their opposition to the new order.
All the countries that continue to impose the death penalty on the population are flying in the face of what the UN believes is the principal position to end this.
And though Catholic leaders and human rights advocates are urging the policy to be reconsidered, the White House is signaling Trump's full support for the change.
The president's made very clear he wants stiffer penalties for high-level drug traffickers. We're actually hopeful that some legislation can be introduced and passed on a bipartisan basis.